Hello, everyone. We are Young and Chromass, the chromatograph manufacturer to make your analysis better. In this video, comprehensive solutions for gas analysis will be described by focusing on the optimized GC configurations. Gas samples exist as gaseous phase at ambient temperature like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and light hydrocarbons under C5, such as carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. There are three things you should consider for optimization of GC configuration, which are column, detector, and sampling method. The first thing is the use of right column. The right column selection is important depending on which gas you analyze. These are the most commonly used columns for gas analysis. Carboxin 1000 column is used for separation of oxygen, nitrogen, methane, carbon monoxide, and carbon dioxide. Molecular sieve 5A and 13X columns improve the separation of permanent gases and have good resolution for carbon monoxide, but they are not suitable to separate carbon dioxide and hydrocarbons over C2. Because these compounds easily get stuck into the column. So it is important to condition the column to get rid of moisture and carbon dioxide that might be absorbed in the column when you get a new one. HACCP and Parapac columns are useful to separate hydrocarbons C1 to C5, carbon dioxide, water, and hydrogen sulfide, but not for oxygen, nitrogen, and carbon monoxide. The second thing is the right detector selection. The right detector selection depending on concentration of gas samples is required. Flame ionization detector, thermal conductivity detector, and pulsed discharge detector are the most commonly used detectors for gas analysis. The FID is the most commonly used detector in GC analysis, and it selectively detects organic compounds, including CH bond, which can be ionized by hydrogen air flame. It also detects low level of carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide by converting them into methane with the methanizer. TCD detects compounds based on thermal conductivity difference, which means it responds to most of compounds except for carrier gas. It's able to re-detect compounds eluted from TCD by the other detector because TCD is a non-destructive detector. PDD, as a universal detector, can detect all compounds at trace level except for helium, the carrier gas, so it uses for trace level gas analysis. The third thing is gas sampling method. With a gas-tight syringe, it takes sample directly and injects to GC, but the reproducibility might vary depending on user skills. On the other hand, with a gas sampling valve, it can take gaseous sample in accurate and precise amount through a sample loop. As you see the valve diagrams, the sample loop is filled with the gas samples and the carrier gas flows to the column when the valve is off. When the valve is switched on, the carrier gas delivers the sample in the loop to the column. If you want to analyze various gas samples by one GC, you need to configure GC with complex of columns and detectors. In the next series, we're going to look into how to analyze transformer oil gas in detail.